In this video, I'm going to show you how to account for convertible debt. So let's say you're an investor and a company promises to pay you $1,000 5 years from now, right? And they're going to give you interest until then. But they also say, you know what, if you want to, at any point in time before we pay you back that $1,000, you can convert your debt into equity. You could get 20 common shares of stock in our company. Then you're no longer going to have any debt. We don't owe you any money, but you are now an equity holder. So basically, convertible debt would have two different features. So there's a debt component, but then there's also a conversion component, which is basically like an option. Okay. Now, under US GAAP, this is all treated as debt. Okay. And I'm going to show you the journal entries in a minute. With certain exceptions, it could be bifurcated into two different parts. We got the debt and the conversion feature. Under IFRS, which I'll make another video on, under IFRS, you're going to separate out these two components and account for them differently. So you're going to have the debt, and then this is going to be treated as equity. Okay, but let's stick with US GAAP in this video, and we'll get to IFRS in the next video. So what are the benefits for the investor of doing this? Why would an investor want to buy convertible debt? Well, the nice thing is you get a secure cash flow. You're going to be getting interest. But if the company takes off, right, if something great happens and it's like, oh, wow, this company is becoming really valuable. You know what? I want to own equity because these shares are going to be worth a lot of money. Forget about the interest and the debt repayment and everything. I want to be a common shareholder. Okay. Now, the benefits for the borrower, okay, the company issuing the debt, is that they're going to get a lower interest rate because instead of, let's say, maybe normally they'd have to pay 10% interest, they maybe end up paying 4% interest because, again, of that conversion feature. So they're getting a lower cost of borrowing. And if you do end up converting and getting shares of stock, if the investor does that, they're giving up fewer shares than they would have if they had just straight up raised all the money with a straight up equity issuance. Okay, so let's get into the journal entries. So broccoli sandwiches, ooh, that sounds delicious, doesn't it? Issues $100,000 of bonds at par. Okay, so I'm doing it at par to get rid of the premium and discount. So we can just have a straightforward example. And let's say the bonds are convertible to 20,000 common shares. Okay, so we got a convertible debt issuance here. How is the company that is borrowing the money, how are they going to deal with this? So they're going to debit cash for $100,000 and they're going to credit bond payable for $100,000. Okay, if the bonds were issued at a premium or discount, we would also have an extra line for that. Now notice, this is US GAAP, so we don't have any line item here about equity. Okay, we're just straight up accounting for this as a liability. They just issued a bond. Okay, now if there's conversion, and by the conversion I mean they say, okay, you know what, we decided we don't want to be debt holders. We don't want to be your creditors. We now want to be common shareholders. Forget about the debt. We'll just take 20,000 common shares. Okay, so if the investor does that and there's conversion, then we're going to have to get rid of the bond payable. We have to get it off the balance sheet. So we're going to debit bond payable for $100,000. And we're going to credit equity for $100,000. But you see, I got split up into two accounts here, common stock and paid in capital. I'm assuming here, okay, I'm assuming that it's a dollar par value per share. Okay, I just made that up. It wasn't in the given information. And there was 20,000 shares that they're getting, a dollar par value per share, 20,000 times a dollar. So I'm crediting common stock for 20,000, and the extra amount to make the journal entry balance is the 80,000 credit to additional paid in capital. Okay, if this was no par stock, then it would just all go to common stock and you wouldn't have an additional paid in capital. Now, so that's how you would account for the conversion. Basically, you get the liability off the books and then you credit the equity accounts. Now, sometimes to get if let's say the company that borrowed the money really wants the investors to convert and to say, you know what, yeah, we're gonna take common shares. We don't want the debt repaid. This is called an induced conversion. To induce a conversion, sometimes the borrower will offer something called a sweetener. Okay, they'll offer a sweetener. So they say, for example, they say, look, we really want you to exercise this option and become an equity holder, and we don't want to repay the debt. We just want to give you shares. Okay, we want you to have shares. So we're going to pay you $3,000 cash as a kicker, right, as a sweetener to get you to go along with us. So basically, the journal entry would be the same as above, but we're now going to debit debt conversion expense and credit cash for $3,000. So if the conversion had been induced instead of the example I gave you before where there was no sweetener, You're still going to take the bond payable off the balance sheet by debiting it. You're still going to credit common stock and paid-in capital, but now you're going to debit debt conversion expense and credit cash for $3,000. Okay, so that was a hypothetical situation. Now, let me give you another hypothetical. Let's assume, so in these examples, I'm assuming that they convert, okay, that there's a conversion. But what if there's no conversion? What if the investors never decide, yeah, we want to convert these to the debt to common shares? What if they just stay with the debt and they say, we don't want to convert? Okay, well, if there's retirement, right? So you retire the debt at some point, okay, the company that borrowed the money, they're going to credit cash for $100,000 when they repay the debt, right, to retire it, and debit bonds payable. Now, if they pay more or less than that, okay, let's say there's an early retirement of the debt, okay, you could have a situation where you have a gain or a loss. And that'd be similar to just early retirement of any type of bond, whether it's convertible or not.